council, as the only official representative of the people of Roanoke, should long since have given its attention to remedying these deficiencies. Mr. Young speaks of the wasted time and effort of the present controversy. It would seem obvious to me that some of the council's time and effort, instead of engaging in a controversy with its responsible citizens, as it has done, could have been expended in insisting to the Civil Aeronautics Board that some of America's deficiencies be remedied.